Philippine shares, contrarians again, this time to the downside, skipping a relief rally in Asia triggered by dovish comments from Federal Reserve Chief Jerome Powell's testimony on Capitol Hill. All eyes also on the Trump-Kim summit in Hanoi, Vietnam, the second meeting between the two leaders in less than a year.
The biggest upside is if Kim makes a decision on the with regards to the plans to stop any nuclear armament for North Korea. But that seems unlikely at the moment. For any form of stability, I think in general for politics in the Asian region is good for markets.
On the local front, investors look to GDP growth and earnings for reason to either buy or dump the market. BPI Securities is keeping a more bullish outlook on GDP, while it says earnings so far are mostly meeting expectations.
Actually, most of the numbers have been meeting expectations. So that's been that's actually an improvement from what we've seen. You know, we saw probably two quarters ago when a lot of companies are really impacted by falling margins on the back of inflation. It's really GDP growth. We're actually looking at around 6.8-6.9% GDP growth for 2019. But if you take a look at consensus numbers, they're looking at roughly 6.4-6.5%. So what could drive that? I would think maybe consumption.
For the day, the PSE index tumbled back to the 7,800 level, its lowest in a week. Foreign funds sold down and out of the market too. Among the day's big drags, Jollibee Foods, Metrobank, JG Summit, SM Investments, and PLDT. PLDT shares now at their lowest since 2004.
Investors are selling down on PLDT because there are numerous headwinds for this business. So first, Duterte is really focusing on their business. They have several issues like the labor and the tax issues. And right now, the president is threatening to shut down their operations on the fundamental side. There are also issues with regards to competition. Globe is overtaking PLDT in terms of the mobile subscribers, and there's the risk of the third telcos.
Important to note, Villar-led stocks led winners for the day.
In corporate stories, low-cost housing developer 8990 Holdings is partnering with Megawide again, this time for horizontal development in Bulacan.
Megawide will bring its precast expertise to produce 5,000 townhouses with an 8990 Holdings 41-hectare property in Macawayan. This in addition to 8990 Holdings' Marilao project. 8990 shares buck the downswing, rising over 3.5%. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.